Hey mates, I'm Alex.
And I'm Gaston.
Welcome to Power Mate.
This is a place to learn and share about Fabric and Power Platform. If this is your first time here, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this channel with your friends and colleagues.
So welcome again, Power Mate. Today, we are going to dive into Microsoft Fabric and Azure Databricks. So stay with us as we guide you through how to integrate them and what are those typical use cases. So let's ask our Microsoft Fabric buddy, Gaston, please guide us on this topic.
Yeah, right on, Alex. Let's start covering some of the basic concepts. And for that, let's go over to my machine. So, first of all, how does Azure Databricks work with Microsoft Fabric? With the recent announcement of Microsoft Fabric, these questions might have appeared in your social media feed. So first, let's quickly recap on some of the basic concepts around both products. First of all, Azure Databricks is a unified set of tools for deploying, sharing, and maintenance enterprise-grade data and AI solution at scale. Azure Databricks today has a widespread adoption from organizations of all sizes for use as a data processing and analytics engine, as well as a data scientist platform. On the other hand, Microsoft Fabric is, as we know, a unified analytics platform that brings together all the data analytics tools that organizations might need. Fabric brings together experience such as data engineer, data factory, data science, data warehouse, real-time analytics, and Power BI onto a one single shared SaaS foundation, all seamlessly integrated into a single service. As well, Microsoft Fabric comes with one lake. Remember that one lake is a big concept across all the framework and where you can land the data. As well, you can reference the data leveraging shortcuts. That is a single place to store all your organizational data.
That's awesome, Gaston. So could you give us an example on how to leverage this integration and why it's important to understand both frameworks?
Yeah, sure thing. Let's go over to my machine again, so I can capture the definition of some of the concepts that we might want to track. First of all, in our last episode, remember that we talked about shortcuts and the importance of one lake to enable the data to be reused without copying the data. So the shortcut function is kind of a symbolic link to the data. We can create shortcuts to any data within one lake or to external data lakes, such as ADLS Generation 2 or Amazon S3 buckets. So, going to our main topic, many data lakes today are built leveraging Azure Databricks as an analytics process engine. The data is physically stored in ADLS Generation 2, but is transformed and cleaned using Databricks. With shortcuts to existing ADLS data, it is made ready for consumption through one lake and Fabric. One typical use case is to leverage these shortcuts, as we see here, and build lakehouses on top of this data, leveraging Direct Lake mode, allowing this data to be queried with fast performance directly over data in one lake. The data is the same created data that our data science team is using to train ML models in Databricks. Direct Lake model is going to enable improved performance over an existing ingestion framework without any kind of need to copy that data.
Great concept. And one more question is, what is going to happen if I keep adding more data to the created zone via Databricks?
Good call. Let's go over again to my machine and let me share a little bit of some of the insights around this logic on integrating both frameworks. Let's say that you're working on a medallion architecture with multiple data sources and external ones, and after That one, you call cleansing and transform your layer. You have the data available in one lake. In that case, the data is going to be up to date every time you land new data into your lakehouse. And so then Power BI users, either since the direct lake mode, they are going to be accessing the latest data from one lake all the time.
Oh, okay, and so continue with the same question, Gaston, is this integration work in the other way? Meaning, Databricks is able also to read and write data from one lake?
That's a really interesting topic. And, you know, because everyone is talking about medallion architectures mm-hmm. with multiple data source, external data source, and, you know, if you are working with many data engineers team that they are more cleansing the data, transforming the data into one layer, and that data is available in one lake, you can serve the data in one lake also to Azure Databricks users. So they can reach the data into one lake. And since the APIs are shared between ADLS and one lake, all your users from the data scientist teams from Databricks can access and query your one lake data.
Oh, awesome. I think you answered my question and super clear. Okay. All right, PowerMate, that wraps up today's episode. We hope you are as excited as we are about the potential of Azure Databricks, Microsoft Fabric, and Power Platform.
Stay tuned, because in our next episode, we will be moving forward with this topic and going into a step-by-step configuration process integrating Azure Databricks and Microsoft Fabric in a real and live example.
Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, hit that notification bell, and join us on this journey.
Together, let's unlock the full potential on Power Platform and Microsoft Fabric.
See ya.